Let us now discuss some cases of reducing pressure by increase in area. These are the examples I am taking which are used in our day-to-day life also, like rear wheels of a tractor are brought to reduce pressure on soft agriculture land. Here you can see the picture. You might have seen various pictures of a tractor in which the rear wheels tires are kept broad. And these are kept broad because the whole weight of tractor, which is majority of weight of tractor, which is on the rear wheels, will reduce the pressure on soil. Otherwise, if these tires are kept narrow or thin, in that case, the effect of the weight of tractor on land will be large, and these tires may penetrate deep into the soil and tractor may stuck up somewhere in the soil. Now, another example here we can see that foundations of high-rise buildings are kept wide to reduce pressure on land. Here in this picture, you can see a high-rise building. In a high-rise building, weight is concentrated at its bottom, and because of which, if we just have a look on its foundation, it is kept quite wide so that the weight is distributed over the whole surface of the foundation, because of which the pressure is less. So the overall weight is distributed in the whole foundation area, and due to less pressure, the building may not penetrate into the sand to a larger depth. It is kept at a specific level due to this wide foundation. If the foundation is of the same size as that of land, the building may penetrate into the soil up to some distance also with time. So such wide foundations keep buildings stable. Another example here we can see, like broad feet animals like camel can walk easily in sand because of reduced pressure. You know well that camels can easily walk in sand in desert area. This is because of their broad feet. As the weight of camel is distributed over the large area of the feet do not penetrate deep into the sand, and camel can walk easily.